Hello again, everyone. Edwin Lernard back once again. In this YouTube astrological segment, I'm going to be talking about Scorpio relationships, and yes, this does apply and pertain to the Sun, Moon, and Ascendant. Anyway, people, first thing up is, as far as Scorpio relationships go, the first house in astrology generally will reflect the paternal grandmother and maternal grandfather. And Scorpio, of course, falls on the first house cusp in a solar natal chart for Scorpio. So, one or both these people may have a Scorpio Sun, Moon, or Ascendant, or simply embody Scorpio-like characteristics. They could be people perhaps that are very probing, secretive, mysterious, maybe even a little surreptitious. They could be people also that are very resourceful, resilient, have a strong will, have a strong willpower, indomitable spirit, can be ones that at the same time might be a little bit vengeful and vindictive, though, at the same time. Now, one or more of these people may also be involved in a Scorpio-like profession, such as working as a coroner, a mortician, sex therapist, psychologist, psychiatrist, doing something with investigation, forensics, working in the occult, or doing some kind of astrological work, something connected with the supernatural. Also, too, as far as the relationship goes with these people, well, it may be one where you're really able to detect subterfuge and superficiality, and it's probably very hard to prevaricate and lie to one another, and one where you really may not share a lot with each other. Scorpio energy, of course, can be very secretive, but ones, too, where, given that this is Scorpio energy, could be very powerful, intense connection, but it's sometimes destructive. So, anyway, next thing up is, well, as far as Scorpio relationships go, the third house in astrology represents siblings and cousins. And Capricorn often falls on the third house cusp in a solar or natal chart for Scorpio. So one or more of these people may have a Capricorn Sun, Moon, or Ascendant, or simply embody Capricorn characteristics. They could be people that are very serious, responsible, very consistent, ones that are very orthodox and conventional, people that really might have a difficult time showing that whimsical side. They might be seen as somewhat cold, callous, and undemonstrative, even somewhat melancholy, perhaps. So, also, too, one or more of these people may be involved in a Capricorn-like profession, such as working in dentistry, being a career counselor, some kind of business administration, working as doing something connected with authority, working as a landlord, a manager, working in government, politics, information technology. And as far as the relationship goes with one or more of these people, it can be one that's very consistent, one that's very serious, and one in which you have a lot of responsibility, perhaps with maybe it works on both ends. Can be too, where maybe there's difficult, whenever you have Capricorn in a chart, can reflect where there might be some restrictions or limitations, and you might feel there's something limited or restricted as far as this goes. Now, anyway, next thing up, as far as Scorpio relationships go, the fourth house in astrology represents the less dominant parent, which is often the mother, and Aquarius often falls on the fourth house cusp in a solar or natal chart for Scorpio. So this could be, this person may be somebody that might be an Aquarius Sun, Moon, or Ascendant, or simply embody Aquarius-like characteristics. It could be someone that could be somewhat eccentric, unorthodox, eclectic, maybe a little bit bizarre, unusual, maybe somebody that might be rather unpredictable, innovative, inventive, ingenious, someone you might see as very unique and very non-conforming. Now, it could also be that this person might be involved in Aquarius profession. It could be working as a social advocate or environmental engineering. It could be working in astronomy, esoteric subjects such as astrology, rocket science, innovation, working in a computers or electronics field or vocation. And as far as the relationship goes with this person, it can be one where you might actually see this person more as a friend than you actually do an actual relative. And it may be one where it might have certain unpredictability in it and unconventionality. There might be something unusual about, unorthodox about this connection you may have with this person. So, anyway, and it could also be one where you show a lot of selflessness back and forth with each other and humanitarian type qualities. So, anyway, next thing up is as far as Scorpio relationships go. Well, the fifth house in astrology represents children and love slash romantic relationships. And Pisces often falls on the fifth house cusp in a solar or natal chart for Scorpio. This could be one or more of these people may be a Pisces sun, moon, or ascendant, or simply embody Pisces-like characteristics. They could be people that may be rather intuitive, maybe some may be mediumistic. It could be people that are very sensitive with all-encompassing emotions, ones that are very idealistic, compassionate, ones that see the best in others and make the best out of adverse circumstances. People that might be a little bit confusing, even and unclear, and even somewhat nebulous, and in the negative sense, I mean, could also be somewhat deceptive and duplicitous. Now, could also be one or more of these people may be involved in a Pisces-like profession. It could be someone that might work in the metaphysical, which of course includes astrology, somebody that works as a medium, a psychic, bartending, counselor, addiction, maybe somebody that works in oceanography, a person that may work in chemistry, photography, special effects, illusion. I mean, illusion could be working as a magician, illusionist, and going back to special effects like in movies. So, anyway, or something connected with fantasy. So, also, too, as far as the connection goes in relationship with one or more of these people, it can be one where a lot of idealism is expressed, and you try to overlook the transgressions of one another, but at the same time, it could be marred or tarnished with some deception and duplicity as well. And it might be that you might see one or more of these people as somewhat nebulous and unclear or even obscure. So, anyway, next thing up is as far as Scorpio relationships go. Well, the sixth house in astrology represents the less dominant parent sibling. So these are aunts and uncles represented. And one or more of these people can be I mean, Aries will often fall on the sixth house cusp in a solar or natal chart for Scorpio. So one or more of these people may be an Aries sun, moon, or ascendant, or simply embody Aries-like characteristics. They could be people that are very, I mean, could be very outspoken, forthright, straightforward, direct. People that don't mince words, that are rather fearless, have a lot of courage and fortitude. Ones that can be somewhat combative and confrontational, as well, and maybe a little bit acerbic, even, and a little bit abrupt. So, anyway, also, too, as far as this goes, well, one or more of these people may be in an Aries-like profession, and it could be, I mean, for example, working as an EMT, surgeon, welding, doing something connected with leadership, sports, working in some Maybe even teaching some kind of combative sports such as karate, boxing, wrestling, mixed martial arts. Someone that may, I mean, do something associated with fire, such as working in an arson investigation, firefighting. And also, too, as far as the connection and relationship goes with one or more of these people, it can be one where, I mean, where you really have to show a lot of initiative and enterprise and don't want to waste time and activities connected with these people, a little procrastination and hesitation, but one that can be somewhat combative and confrontational at times. But at the same time, these people may be willing to stick up for you in a heartbeat and you as well, perhaps for them. And also one where there's a lot of outspokenness and straightforwardness at the same time, where you're very forthright with each other and you generally will likely know where you stand with each other at in most instances, at most times. So anyway, well, the next thing up is as far as Scorpio relationships go, the seventh house in astrology represents a significant other, marriage partner, and maternal grandmother and paternal grandfather. So at least generally speaking, it will. Now, the zodiac sign Taurus, of course, is going to fall on the seventh house cusp in a solar or natal chart for Scorpio. So one or more of these people may have a Taurus sun, moon, or ascendant, or simply embody Taurus-like characteristics. They could be people that are very stolid, steady, reliable, ones that can be somewhat implacable, obstinate, stubborn, even. People that are also very loyal and steadfast, and ones that could be very persistent. People that come through on what they're going to say and do very have a very strong dependable element to them, but you might see them as perhaps boring even. And as far as this goes as well, one or more of these people may be involved in a Taurus profession, such as working as a banker, a stockbroker, a financial planner, doing construction, architecture, banking, working as a cashier, and even working perhaps as a general or mundane type of position or worker, such as just like working in retail as a general worker. So anyway, as far as the relationship and connection goes with these people, it can be one where it's very steady, it's there's reliability. It's one where you show a lot, where I mean the people and you might express this toward them, a lot of loyalty and steadfastness, a lot of persistence as well. And but it might be one where you might find where it gets a little bit overly monotonous and boring as well, and also where stubbornness and obstinacy might be expressed at the same time. So anyway. Next thing up is, well, as far as Scorpio relationships go, well, the eighth house in astrology represents sexual and intimate relationships. And Gemini often falls on the eighth house cusp in a solar or natal chart for Scorpio. So one or more of these people may have a Gemini sun, moon, or ascendant, or simply embody Gemini-like characteristics. They could be people that are very mercurial, whimsical, fickle, very changeable, vacillating, but ones that really disdain monotony. They could be very communicative, ones that are very loquacious and talkative, talk about a wide divergence of subjects, and also ones that could be very versatile and really are strongly about variety and may be very dexterous and be able to work with the hands very well, but you might see them as some might be somewhat superficial at the same time. Now, and one or more may be in a Gemini-like profession, such as working in a communications field, like working as a journalist, a reporter, even a broadcasting, writing, doing public speaking. Could also be someone that might even just work as like a floater in a store, where there's a lot of job variety. Somebody in a communications field, again, know some other examples, data communication, satellite communication, doing something where you show a lot of dexterity, where they show a lot of dexterity, such as working as an auto or refrigeration mechanic. Now, as far as the connection and relationship go with these people, it could be where it's really a little bit, you know, on the surface and superficial. One where you have a lot of variety, but one in which you also desire a lot of mental and intellectual stimulation and very good conversation, being able to talk about a wide divergence of subjects, and one that doesn't become old or boring or monotonous, because Gemini energy, of course, is certainly not boring. It's probably the antithesis of that, actually. So anyway, well, the next thing up as far as Scorpio relationships go, well, the ninth house in astrology represents in-laws and grandchildren. And the zodiac sign Cancer will often fall on the ninth house cusp in a solar or natal chart for Scorpio. So it could be, one or more of these people may have a Cancer sun, moon, or ascendant, or simply embody Cancerian-like characteristics. My grandmother had a Scorpio rising and likely had Cancer on her ninth house cusp in her natal chart. And sure enough, I'm a grandchild. My sun sign is Cancer, and she had two other grandchildren, and one of them had the sun in Cancer, and the other one has a Cancer ascendant. And I was going to marry somebody many years ago, around 1989, 1990, and that woman had a Cancer ascendant. So that would have been, I guess you could say, a daughter-in-law, potentially for, and that would have been another Cancerian person there. So I thought that was very interesting. Anyway, going back to Cancer often being on the ninth house cusp in a solar natal chart for Scorpio, well, these people also can exhibit Cancerian characteristics. They could be people that are very nurturing, protective, supportive, sympathetic, show a lot of compassion, very emotional, but yet temperamental, fickle, and moody, and ones that are very nostalgic, but can really reminisce a lot about the past, sometimes for better or for worse. Also, too, one or more of these people represented maybe in a Cancerian profession, such as working as a home caregiver, somebody that is involved in cooking, a culinary field, doing someone that does home repair, renovation, restoration, roofing, siding, working in real estate, doing restaurant work, working in fast food, even perhaps. Now, as far as the connection and relationship goes with one or more of these people, it could be one where a lot of nurturing energy is showed, where a lot of sympathy is expressed, one where there's very strong emotions, and one where you might spend a lot of time in the home, might be dominated by home activities, and also one where you're very perhaps protective of one another as well. So those are some things to look at. Now, anyway, getting to the, as far as Scorpio relationships go, getting to the 10th house. Now, the 10th house in astrology represents the dominant parent, which is usually the father. And Leo often falls on the 10th house cusp in a solar or natal chart for Scorpio. So, this could be someone that may have a Leo sun, moon, or ascendant, or simply embody Leo-like characteristics. It could be somebody that's very proud, dignified, but yet domineering, flamboyant, very showy. Could be rather extravagant, a person that might have a lot of courage and fortitude, might have a very strong, dominant personality. You might see them as overbearing, though, at times, and perhaps even ostentatious. The next thing up is, as far as this goes, it could be someone, too, that may be in a Leo-like profession. It could be somebody that might be connected with theater, drama, entertainment, working in amusement, like such as an amusement park, doing maybe somebody that does some kind of game designing, which could, encompass many things, such as working as a video game designer or board game designer, perhaps. Somebody that might work in some creative field or working with children, even. And as far as the relationship goes with this person, it can be one where you may see the person as somewhat domineering. There can be, it couldn't be one though, where you take a lot of pride in and where a lot of courage and fortitude is expressed, but a lot of extravagance as well. It could be spending a lot of money on each other. Where where there's generosity expressed very strongly, and really where there's one where I think maybe there might be some battle for attention as well, and this person might be wanting, really clamoring for attention from you. Leo energy can be like that. It's really a lot about that attention. So anyway. Well, the next thing up is as far as Scorpio relationships go, the 11th house in astrology represents friends and stepchildren. And Virgo will often fall on the 11th house cusp in a solar or natal chart for Scorpio. So, one or more of these people can be a Virgo sun, moon, or ascendant, or simply embody Virgo-like characteristics. It can be people that are rather frugal, thrifty, persnickety, ones that might unfortunately be judgmental, critical, fastidious. They could be very meticulous dressers, people that are very, could even be neat freaks, sometimes even compulsive complainers as well, but ones that can be about a lot of service and not, and generally not done in an officious or unwanted manner. Now, also, too, one or more of these people may be involved in a Virgo-like profession, such as something connected with extrapolation of data, could be some other examples, data entry, working in a nutrition field, computer programming, anything that might be detail-oriented, which could include even detailing vehicles, doing something connected with health and fitness, perhaps working as a fitness trainer. Dietitian, some examples, doing maybe even working as a doctor. Now, also too, as far as the connection and relationship go with one or more of these people, it can be one where you do provide a strong service to one another, and generally, as I stated before, not in an officious or unwanted manner, but ones where you generally want to help each other and be of service for one another. It can be one too where you could be rather critical and judgmental of each other. A lot of times it might just be seen though as constructive criticism. And ones where you might not really spend a lot of money on each other. Virgo can be rather a frugal energy. So anyway, and you might be into a lot of analysis together, whether analyzing each other or what have you. So anyway. The next thing up, last but not least, as far as Scorpio relationships go, the 12th house in astrology represents the dominant parents' siblings. So aunts and uncles are represented, and Libra often falls on the 12th house cusp in a solar or natal chart for Scorpio. So one or more of these people may have a Libra sun, moon, or ascendant. Or simply embody Libra-like characteristics. They could be people that are very cultured, charming, refined, diplomatic, tactful, people that are very balanced, that are very equitable, are about fairness, and ones that could also abhor injustice. So, really, those are some things to look at as far as this goes. And also too, one or more of these people may be in a Libra-like profession, such as working as a marriage counselor, human resources, involved in art in some way, maybe some profession connected with beauty, such as working as a model, acting, actors, actresses, could be someone that works in a law field, such as working as an attorney, judge, paralegal, bailiff, a court reporter. And as far as the connection and relationship go with one or more of these people, well, it can be one that's very balanced, very fair-minded, where where you're all very equitable in connection with each other's needs and in the time spent. One that is balanced, a one two where generally not confrontational, but where one may call the other out or another out if something is not fair or just. And it can be one where you express a lot of charming qualities as well, and where you express certain tact and diplomacy, which Scorpio generally may not do. But in these relationships, it might be expressed a little bit stronger. So anyway, that'll conclude this YouTube astrological segment for Scorpio relationships. And stay tuned next time, where I am going to be giving you my take on the March 31st, 2018 full moon in Libra. Two things I want to get with you on before I head out. Firstly, the stars may impel, but do not compel. And secondly, never isolate any single astrological element, aspect, planetary placement, position, configuration, influence, or what have you, and make an analysis of a person, astrologically speaking, based on this alone, because astrologically speaking, the person is the sum of all their components in their natal chart and not just one. Until next time, people, stay well.